In this video, let's see this problem which was asked again in the CBSE previous year examination 2004 year. So the problem is integrate sine inverse x whole square. Now inverse function is there, inverse trigonometric I must say. Sine inverse x are 2 and they are multiplied. So can we just break these up? Breaking up means what? Breaking up I mean is I write I is equal to sine inverse x product sine inverse x dx. Now, if I have to substitute, because inverse functions both would not allow me to use I late. Indirectly, I can directly use it, but not as such direct. So, what I do is to simplify, write, put sine inverse x is equal to t, that means sine t is equal to x, or I have to then differentiate. So, sine differentiation is cos t dt is equal to dx. So these can be made as some equations, they will help me in the further part of the solution. So what is now I? I is sine inverse x, that is t. Sine inverse x again is t, fine. And as you can see, this should not be dt, this is a mistake. This has to be dx. Now, here it is sine inverse x, that means t square. And dx is cos t dt. So it is cos t dt. Now I late now I can use because I have trigonometric also and algebraic also. So it is algebraic and trigonometric. So first and second you have decided. Now let's move forward. The formula would be first function into integration of second minus differentiation of first into integration of second holds integration. As you can see, integration would be t square cos t, wherein t square is your first function, cos t is your second function. So first function into integration of second, and you know sine's differentiation was cos, so directly first function into integration of second minus differentiation of first, so it is 2t into integration of second holds integration. Let's move to the further part of the board for the further solution. For most steps, it is t square sine t. So first function into integration of second, this symbol gets removed. Let's remove this symbol at the very first go. So it is t square sine t. Then minus 2. Now again, you have one algebraic, one trigonometric, first function, second function. Now first function into integration of second, so it is t into integration of sine minus cos t. Then differentiation of first function into integration of second minus differentiation of first. So minus 1 or simply minus sign. Into integration of second. Integration of second would be again minus cos t. So minus minus becoming plus. Right? You can see that I have done this thing. So again I repeat what I did. I had 2 already. I wrote 2 already. Then first function into integration of second. First function into integration of second. Minus sign. You wrote earlier minus. Differentiation of first into integration of second. Then holds integration. So you have to do this integration again. Okay, so now the next step after this would be, I have t square sine t copied as it is. Minus minus becoming plus, so plus 2t cos t minus plus becoming minus integration of cos t with respect to t. Now again, t square sine t plus 2t cos t minus 2. What is the integration of cos? It is nothing but sine t plus c. Now I cannot leave my answer here because it should not be left in the terms of t. So I have t there, so I have to use x in terms of it. So it is sine inverse x whole square. Sine t was nothing but your x plus 2 sine inverse x. Cos t would be under root 1 minus x square from 2 plus, in fact it should be minus 2 sine t. Sine t. Sine t is what? As you can see, sine t is your x. So minus 2 x plus c. and that is your answer to this question. But you have to use that, the equations, whatever you have to use, you have to write. So you have been using equation number 1, equation number 2. So I write here from 1 and 2.